Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about icon troubleshooting. Sometimes when you're designing with icons in Adobe Illustrator, you'll come across various problems. Sometimes they won't have the same look and feel, and that's something that you really need to have when you're wanting your look to be cohesive across your project. So the outlines also need to be the same thickness, and if they are outline icons, the outline line weight needs to be the same thickness. I'm gonna show you a few problems you might come across when you're working with icons. I'm gonna copy these onto a kind of like a fake web page I designed here. And I just wanted to show you what can happen when you put them on a dark background. I'm talking about multicolored icons. I'm gonna just kind of move these and center them up a little bit. This one is not grouped, so I'm going to select that whole thing and group it with Command G. And this one looks to be grouped, okay. If they're not grouped, you want to group everything just right off the bat. It makes it easier when you're grabbing them to grab the whole thing instead of a piece of it. So to do that, just draw a square around the whole thing and then do Command G or Control G on a PC. Okay, so let's work with this first one. As you can see, we're losing a little bit of the image down here at the bottom. We can't see it anymore because it's on the same color background that it is. So one solution you can try is to just in the Command Y mode, you can easily select this with your group selection tool. That's your G tool. And you'll have to set up that key command by yourself. That is keyboard shortcuts. And then it will be under tools. I have it set up here as the group selection tool, the G tool. Now that's usually gradient, but you can use any key you want for that. Anyway, I'll highlight these three bottom things as a group. I get my color to the front and then click white. So now all the parts show up pretty nicely, but I kind of like the way that looked as the darker blue. So the other thing we can try is to copy this image and then add a light stroke to it so you can see the outline. So right now, this is made up of strokes. I can see a stroke here, and then all of the globe stuff is a fill. And we want everything to be a fill. So let's go ahead and expand this. That's Command E. This will bring up this dialog box, and then just say OK. Now we'll copy and paste behind. That's Command B. I'm going to make this all one shape. And to do that, all you have to do is come down here to the Pathfinder and click Unite. And that'll make it all one. Command 3, hide this. You can see it's all become one shape behind it. So I'm going to hide it and we'll work with this. Okay, I'm going to make that background piece a white fill and a white stroke. And I'll bump that up to 4. Well, we'll do 3. And then you want to put the cap in the middle and the corner in the middle, and that rounds everything. So as you can see, we have an outline here. And we have some, okay, that was just a glitch. Moving on to the second one. Now this one has some live type. Because this has live type in it, we definitely want to expand the type or outline, whichever you choose. I'm going to do outline, Shift-Command-O. And then we'll add the outline to this. Copy, paste behind, Command B, and shape, unite. Now we'll add 3-point stroke and we'll round it. Now we're looking pretty similar. Come over here to the brain in the box. I'm going to copy, paste behind, Command B, unite that, and add a slight stroke and round it. Put it at 3. Now when I zoom out, you can see that they all have a very similar look and feel. If I move this icon, it is going to be separate from the one that's just behind it. So you don't want to go ahead and group those. Command G. And I'm going to lock that. Command G and Command G. So they're pretty similar right now. If I was actually making a web page, I would probably change the question marks here to just a solid white with no outline. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to hit D to give a white fill and black outline. That will always do that if you hit the letter D with something selected. And now I'll hit the question mark to clear that black outline. And I'll move them up a little bit. And this down here, I know it's supposed to be part of the magnifying glass, but I think it looks a little weird. So I'm going to take my A tool and draw a box around this part and then move it up. Yeah, about maybe right there. Okay, moving on, I'm going to do the same thing here with the brain in a box. I'm going to hit D and then question mark and move those up a little bit. I probably also resize these a little. So I'm going to grab the first one and I'm going to group it. Let me make sure these are all grouped. Okay, grab the first one and hit S and return. And we'll do a uniform 80%. Same here, S, return, 80%, S, return, 80%. Okay, so they look pretty nice now, I think, about the right size. And we'll center them up ahead of their little captions. The web part is done. Next, I want to show you a way to add a fill and a stroke to outline icons like these. So let's zoom in on this first one. This is built with all outlines. So they do this so you can easily have a different look without having to really manipulate the icon. So you can just change the stroke and it'll make it thicker, thinner, and it's really awesome. But I want to add, so first I'm going to group these. Command G. Command G, Command G, Command G. I'm going to take all four, copy, paste in front, and then I'm going to send them 10 inches to the right. Okay, so there's a copy here, and there's a copy over here that I'll use later. So first I'm going to focus on this one. I'm going to take this piece and combine them. So I'll grab with my A tool this point. And this point and join them with Command J. And I'm going to use this green. I am going to take the stroke and also make it a fill by just pulling like that. Okay, so we have a problem up here. So what I would do is take a copy of this, paste it behind, so that will still leave us with that fill, and then simply delete these points here and paste in front. And that way we can get rid of the fill but leave the stroke. For these wheels, I'm going to hit I, which will give me this tool. Okay, let's see how we did. Maybe we can increase the stroke a little bit here. There we go. So we now have a fill. I'm going to delete this line. And I'm going to add my strokes back to it. Hit V, return, and then minus 10. And then command 0 to get back. Okay, and you can see we've added a little stroke to that. Okay, for something like this icon, we can just take this shape and this shape and copy, paste them behind. So I'm going to do that now. I'm doing that with my G tool. That way you can select parts of the group. Copy. And then I'm going to clear, Shift Command A. And then paste behind. And we'll use the I tool to sample this over here. All right, now we've got a little fill and outline here. And same with this one. You can take the two outermost pieces, copy those, paste behind with Command B. And then sample this green over here. And with the pig, since it's not a completed path here, it's going to be a little bit different. So we'll have to take the whole pig, well, actually just those and the circle. Copy, paste behind, and I'm gonna sample this to see what it does. Oh, it actually did really good. Okay, so we have all of the awesome little filled in icons. The things you're really going to have to watch is when it is an incomplete path like this. That is going to take a little bit of manipulation, but most of them, they're going to be completed paths and you can just add an outline behind it like these. All right, so let me know if you have any questions or you're getting stuck working with icons in Illustrator. This is Anne for Graphic Design How To, and if you like this video, please click the thumbs up. And if you want to see more like this, just subscribe. So give me some feedback in the comment section below if you have any, and I'll see you next week. Thanks, guys.